Imagine an inductor with an inductance denoted as L. If we were to send a current, labeled I, coursing through this inductor, how would we determine the voltage drop across it? In the case of a resistor, this is quite simple. As many of you might recall, the voltage across a resistor is readily calculated using Ohm's law. But what about for our inductor? Can we apply the same principle? Unfortunately, it's not that simple. In this scenario, we're assuming our inductor is crafted from an ideal wire, one that has zero resistance. However, there's another phenomenon at work, which results in a voltage drop across the inductor, and it's entirely separate from resistance. This phenomenon is related to the changing magnetic fields when current flows through the wire. We've delved into the foundational mechanics of an inductor in a previous video, so if you're curious about the details, I'd recommend giving that a watch. That said, the voltage across an inductor can be determined using this equation, where the voltage drop across the inductor is equal to the product of its inductance, L, and the derivative of the current, I, with respect to time. Now, that derivative term might appear a bit intimidating at first glance. But in simpler terms, it represents the change in current over time, or more precisely, the rate at which the current changes. Here's an immediate insight we get from this equation. If the current through the inductor remains constant, the voltage across it will be zero. Even if a whopping 1,000 amperes flows through the inductor, as long as that current stays steady, there's no voltage drop to speak of. We will not get into too much detail of why this happens in this video, but very briefly, when the current flowing through the inductor alters, the magnetic field generated around the wire also changes. This shifting magnetic field, when intersecting with a conductor like our wire, induces a voltage. Now, let's delve into a practical example. We have a setup consisting of a current source and an inductor with an inductance of 1 Henry. We also have a plot that displays how the current varies over time. At the initial moment, t equals 0 seconds, the current stands at 0 amps. Over the next 2 seconds, it linearly rises to reach 1 amp at t equals 2 seconds. Following that peak, it linearly declines back to 0 amps by t equals 4 seconds. Our challenge now is to determine the voltage across the inductor throughout this 4-second interval. Given our understanding of the voltage across an inductor as defined by this equation, let's break down this scenario. From t equals 0 to t equals 2 seconds, the current rises linearly from 0 amp to 1 amp over a 2-second interval. This means the rate of change of current, di by dt, is 1 minus 0 amp over 2 seconds, which is equal to 0.5 amps per second. Since we already know the inductance, L, plugging the values into the equation, we get the voltage across the inductor during this period as 0.5 volts. Continuing on, from t equals 2 seconds to t equals 4 seconds, the current decreases linearly from 1 amp to 0 amp over a 2 second span again. This implies a rate of change of current di by dt, 0 minus 1 amp, over 2 seconds equals minus 0.5 amps per second. Plugging the values into the equation again, we get the voltage across the inductor during this time frame as minus 0.5 volts. Here, the negative sign indicates that the voltage polarity is reversed compared to the first interval. This is due to the decrease in current, which results in an opposing voltage to resist this change. In conclusion, the voltage across the inductor is directly influenced by how the current through it changes over time. If the current remains constant, there's no voltage across it. But the moment the current starts to change, whether it's increasing or decreasing, the inductor responds by inducing a voltage to counteract that change. If you've found this deep dive insightful, please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. We're always working on delivering more enlightening content to demystify the world of electronics for you. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video.